I'm Ron Salisbury, and this is El Cholo. We call it the original because my grandparents had one in 1923, which is no longer here, but my parents started this one in 1927, and this is how we make our green corn tamales. In the early days, you could only get corn in the summertime here, and that generally starts right at the end of April, and it goes into October, and at that point, we're not gonna get the same quality tamale.
At the beginning of the season, we buy the corn and then we peel them and then save the husk. The husk is very important because you have to fold it against it when it's fresh, because after a while it gets kind of dry. So this way it's very easy to handle. And then what we do, we cut it. We put a little bit of cornmeal into the kernels. That's to kind of blend in so it doesn't get too soft. And then we grind them. After the grinder, we take it out. At the same time, we already mix in the butter, the shortening, and the sugar, and a little bit of salt, and the milk. You look to be a little bit kind of foamy, fluffy. So if you whip it too much, it will break. So you have to get it to a consistency of kind of like a meringue kind of a thing. Once we get that to a fluffy consistency, then we take the butter and the shortening into the corn mix. Usually we do it by hand instead of doing it on the machine. That way we kind of feel the consistency.
We have recipes, but nobody works off them. It's been complete hand pass. We all know what it's like. We know that you're not going to change it.
I've been here since 1976. Once you make it for overtime, you know, you kind of eye it and you see when it's ready and when it's not. The Ortega chilies, we want a nice roast flavor, so we roast them and then we dice them. And this goes into the masa, and you're adding slowly. That way you get a right consistency, not too much chili, because really what you want is the flavor of the corn. Yeah, the corn should be the start of the dish.
Our cheese is aged for over a year. It comes from a special farm in Wisconsin.
Now when we assemble the tamales, and you can see Claudia is an expert on it. Claudia usually makes probably around 500 to 1,000 tamales a day. When we fold the tamales, we take the corn husk, we scoop the masa, and then the cheddar cheese, and then we put it down on the wax paper, and then we fold them.
These green corn tamales have been on the menu for 97 years now. I have to assume this recipe started like all traditional households and the Mexican households. It was passed on from mother to daughter and then to their daughter in times. I have 7 children. Not all of them have bus tables, not all of them have washed dishes, but the rite of passage for them was they have all made green corn tamales in the summertime.
Once we put them on the sheet pan and we take them onto our kettle, and we steam them for about 50 minutes to 1 hour and 10 minutes. Yeah, the most we can put on the kettle of the green corn tamales is probably 500. If you put over that, then they don't steam right, and the outside ones will dry, so we do small batches. Now, once we steam them, we take them into the freezer, we cool them down, and then we start packaging them for the transferring to either people that order them or to the other restaurants.
We ship some of our food. I'd say over 95% of what we ship are either the green corn tamales or our margarita mix.
The ones that we keep in the house, and we just take them out of the sheet pan right there. And then we plate them. And we usually do with 2 tamales with a little bit of relleno sauce and sometimes refried beans, yeah. Our relleno sauce consists of tomatoes, Ortega chilies, bell peppers, and fresh spices. And it's one of the very old recipes, and it has a little touch of vinegar and tomato, so it goes very well for the sweetness of the tamales. I love the green corn tamales, and you get actually addicted to them. First time that I make tamales actually was at my mom's house, and she actually forced me to make them. She needed help. That's when I actually started cooking too. From there on, we went and opened a taqueria and things like that. So, and then I came to this country, and that's all I've been doing for the rest of my life.
Besides the green corn tamales, the flour tortillas is one of the other items that has been on the menu from the beginning.
Our recipe calls for a little bit of the shortening and the butter. And then we mix that with the milk, a touch of salt, and they're very flavorful. Because of the butter, it helps them a lot. Butter makes everything better.
To me, it's a beautiful thing to come in and see the ladies making the dough and rolling them out. It's a process that we never want to change. To me, it's such a tradition.
It's been a great pleasure working for El Cholo for this many years and being part of the history.
I've enjoyed sharing this story about what this El Cholo represents and what it means to my life, and it's more than life, it's bigger than life. And how you capture that only comes through time and tradition and bonding with people. And I'm sure the green corn and mollies are one of the greatest tools we've had to bond with people.